Hello guys, welcome back. This is Andrea and the topic of today's video slightly changed from 2 minutes ago because I would have talked about another thing, but instead I changed my mind and today I won't talk about Amethyst Game Engine, that is a game engine written in Rust, which is the main reason why I am trying this game engine. It have another architecture compared to Godot, which is the DoD and ECS. I have to say about this game engine that it's in a really early stage. For example, we don't have an editor, we don't have a lot of features, but anyway I want to try it, so let's start. Do you know what means that I'm wearing another t-shirt? Yes, it means that passed sometimes. I had some problems yesterday to finish the implementation of this game because I had some troubles. Well, these troubles were due to my lacking of knowledge of Rust, that of course delayed the time required in order to implement a game even simple like the following one. And also I had some other problem, but I will talk about it in a moment. I want just to show you the game that I have a system that allow me to move both pads. But the paddle doesn't have a collision because this game engine doesn't have a physics engine yet. And so to implement a collision detection you have to do it manually. So I have implemented a really stupid algorithm that performed the collision detection only around the window here. And also I have implemented another system that performed the bouncing of the ball, that is the one that you see in this moment. Well, to arrive and talk about what I think about this game engine, before I have to say a disclaimer, because everything I say right now can be invalidated by the new features that arrive probably in a moment. Because of course this game engine is in development and it's easy that it receive updates that invalidate what I say. So please take what I say as a hot thought about this engine. Problems that I had were that basically the first step that you have to do in order to understand how this engine works is not trivial, because this engine requires a system for everything you do. For example, to load texture you need a system, then to bind the texture on screen you need another system, to move the ball you need a system, and so on. You need a system for everything, which is not a problem, but the problem is that if you forgot to register a system during the engine initialization, what happens is that when you use that feature the engine crashes, and understand why the engine crashed is not so easy. And when you understand why the engine crashed, it's not trivial find that system located inside the engine. And this is something that I think must be improved. The engine is still in early stage, so I don't want to talk about things that it is missing. But instead now I want to talk about things that to me are really interesting. One thing that this engine does really well is that register a system is really trivial, because you register the system and then inside the system itself you can define all the information that you need, and the game engine take all the components and give to the system, and this makes the creation of the systems really easy, and this is something that I really like. Another thing that I like about this engine, the community is really nice and can be compared to the Godot community. In fact, they are free to help you, and also they are open-minded and they are able to talk about how to improve the engine and things like that. Also must be mentioned that create and maintain an engine with ECS architecture is way more difficult to maintain an engine with object-oriented architecture. So my expectation for this engine is really huge. And for sure, you have to keep an eye on it. In next days, I will continue to develop with this engine in order to explore and also improve my Rust knowledge. In the next video, I want to talk about the ECS architecture and explain how the mindset should be changed between the Godot architecture, for example, and an ECS architecture that can be also implemented in Godot. Let me know what you think about this engine if you already knew it. So, see you next time. Bye!